Good day, learners. Today we're going to learn division, more specific, long division. Now, when we say long division, we often feel worried and concerned because we think it's so difficult, but it is not. We are going to learn a fun way using a memory technique to understand the steps of long division. We can learn it by saying, does McDonald's sell cheeseburgers raw? Now, hopefully, you understand after this presentation and you attempt your math booklet, and once you've completed it and get everything correct, maybe your parents can reward you with a happy meal. So let's look forward to learning long division. Before we get onto understanding long division, let us recap some knowledge. When I say the sum of, you know that I'm talking about addition. When I say the difference of, you know that I'm talking about subtraction. When I say it is the product of, you know that it is the answer to a multiplication sum. But when I say quotient, what do you understand? It is the answer to a division sum. So let's take a look at a division sum and we can see what each number is called. We have the sum 882 divided by 7 equals 126. 882 is called the dividend. The dividend is the number we want to divide. 7 is called the divisor, the number we are dividing by. And our answer, which is 126, is called the quotient, the answer to a division sum. Now that we understand a division sum, let's move on to long division. Long division always seems so difficult to solve, but here's a fun way of remembering the steps used to solve long division. We're going to use the memory technique. The question, does McDonald's sell cheeseburgers raw? Now the first alphabet of every word is going to represent an operation. Something that we need to do, a step that we need to do. Now we can see D, M, S, C, B, R. That is six alphabets. That means there are six steps to long division. So the D stands for divide, and the M, multiply. The S, subtract. The C, check. The B, bring down. And the R, repeat or remainder. So does McDonald's sell cheeseburgers raw? Now boys and girls, you need to by heart, you need to memorize this question. Because if you memorize this question, you will be able to solve your long division. So every time you see a long division sum, you write on the side, does McDonald's sell cheeseburgers raw? And remember, D is for divide, M for multiply, S for subtract, C for check, B for bring down, and R for repeat or remainder. Here are the steps for long division. Step 1, divide. Step 2, multiply. Step 3, subtract. Step 4, check. Step 5, bring down. Step 6, repeat or remainder. Now, boys and girls, the slides to follow will have each step on each slide. Please look carefully at the color of the step and the color of the number. It will direct you as to where we are in the long division and help you understand better. Let us begin. 882 divided by 7. We want to solve this sum by long division using the memory technique, does McDonald's sell cheeseburgers raw? Boys and girls, it's important for you to note how to set out your work. You don't have to set out the whole sum as I have, but you need to ensure that your divisor is before your dividend. Your divisor is 7. You draw a line between them and you draw a line on top of your dividend, which is 882. Your answer goes above the line of your dividend. Boys and girls, when you're bringing down a number, you need to show an arrow. When you're subtracting, you need to show the subtraction sign. And you draw a line, you put your answer below the line. I hope that you will enjoy this long division. Let's get to it. Step one, divide. So we are going to divide the first number or the first digit of the dividend, which is 882, by the divisor, 7. So the first digit is 8. So 8 divided by 7. In other words, how many times does 7 go into the number 8? Okay, if you think about it, it goes in once. So we write 1 on top of the 8. As you can see in red, step 1 divide, and you see the number 1 in red. That's our first step. Now we go on to step 2, the M, and M stands for multiply. So we are going to multiply the answer we got in step 1 to the divisor. In other words, 1 times 7, or 7 times 1. And what is 7 times 1? It is 7. So you write down 7 below 8. And remember, we're going to get to step 3, which is subtract. That is why you see a subtraction sign in front of the yellow 7. Let me say that again. Step 2, multiply. We multiply the 1 on top to the divisor 7. 1 times 7 equals 7. We write it below the 8. So, from this McDonald's our cheeseburger's roll, we've completed does McDonald's. Now we move on to the word sell. And it starts with the S. And step 3 is subtract. So, we've completed step 1 and 2. Now we subtract 8 minus 7. We see a line, draw a line. Below the line, we write the answer to 8 subtract 7. And the answer to 8 subtract 7 is 1. Boys and girls, we have S for subtract in green, and we have the number 1 in green. Step 4, check. We need to check whether the divisor can go into the answer subtracted. So we need to check if 7, which is the divisor, can go into 1. Now we know that it cannot, because 7 is bigger than 1. So if it cannot, then I can successfully move on to the next step. Checking is very important, boys and girls. We mostly skip this step. But if you do the step, it will help you to complete your long division much better. Now we move on to step 5, bring down. Now remember, when we checked, 7 could not go into 1. Because it cannot go into 1, I bring down my next number, which is 8. And it now forms the number 18. Now we ask ourselves, can 7 go into the number 18? Yes, most probably, because 18 is much bigger and 7 is smaller. So that is the reason we bring down. Now we finally reach step 6, the R. Does McDonald's sell cheeseburgers raw? Repeat the steps, or remainder. Right, so we have divided, we've multiplied, we've subtracted, we've checked, and we've brought down. So R stands for repeat. After we bring down, we go back to step 1, and then step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. And we repeat again. As long as there's numbers in the dividend to bring down, we keep repeating. After we've brought down all our numbers, then whatever is left is called the remainder. Let's have a look. So we had the numbers 18 in our previous step. So we start with step 1 again. Step 1 is to divide. So I divide 18 by the divisor 7, which is equal to 2. I write that 2 on top of 8. Then I move to step 2, which is multiply. How do I multiply? What do I multiply? 2 times the divisor. So 2 times 7 is 14. Step 3 is subtract. So I subtract 18 minus 14 equals 4. I have to check according to step 4. Can 7 go into 4? No. So if I get a no, that means I must bring down the next number. And I bring down the 2. And it forms the number 42. Now, I move on to step 6, which is repeat. Right, so what do I do in step 1? Divide. How many times does 7 go into 42? 7 goes into 42 6 times. Go back to step 2. Multiply. 6 times 7 equals 42. Third step, subtract. 42 minus 42 is 0. Now I have no numbers to bring down and I have 0 for my answer. There is no remainder and I don't need to repeat the steps. That means I've completed long division and I found my answer of 126. 882 divided by 7 equals 126. 126 is called the quotient. And finally, boys and girls, we have completed a long division sum.